Los Angeles, Los Angeles County's public health director said Thursday, October 14, indoor bars and large event venues such as Dodger Stadium have been in generally good compliance with new COVID-19 vaccination requirements for patrons, acknowledging that the adjustment to enforcing the rules can take. But overall, health inspectors have not reported any major issues, Barbara Ferrer said. I think it will take another few days, particularly at these large venues, because as you know, Dodger Stadium is 53,000 plus at these games, and they're full, Ferrer said during an online briefing. I think they're going their very best to be in full compliance. And this gets easier as they're able to work out any of the challenges that are happening at the gates, she said. Ferrer said inspectors also found high compliance at indoor bars, which are now required to verify proof of at least one vaccine dose for employees and patrons. Full vaccination will be required on November 4. There are some places where there wasn't compliance and a good understanding of how the compliance needed to work, but I do want to note that even in sites where we noted they weren't in full compliance, we had no issues with a mandate, Ferrer said. Nobody was saying they weren't going to be in compliance. I'm sure there might be some of those places, and we would anticipate that. But all of the sites that got visited over the weekend, folks were eager to figure out how they could go ahead and make sure they were creating this extra layer of protection for folks. She acknowledged that inspectors visited only a small fraction of the county's thousands of indoor bars, but she was pleased with where we are with compliance from bars and event venues. Ferrer also noted that officials at outdoor venues and the county's two theme parks, Six Flags Magic Mountain and Universal Studios Hollywood, have reported that the vast majority of patrons are arriving equipped with required vaccine verification documents. I want to thank both the establishment. The county reported another 19 COVID-19 deaths on Thursday, lifting the overall virus death toll to 26,372. Another 142 cases were also reported, giving the county a cumulative pandemic total of 1,474,518.